All right, and now we're going to start the Play Some Game Show 10th Anniversary Special Edition. Today we're going to introduce all kinds of information on Play Some titles, campaigns, and sales and stuff. And I'll be your announcer for today, Chiaki Matsuzawa. All right, let's go ahead and introduce a couple of people that we've seen before at previous Play Some Game Shows. First, from Play Some is Shinji Mizutani. I'm Shinji Mizutani. I'm the Play Some dude. Next is Gatchaman V. Hello everyone, I'm a Let's Player named Gatchaman V. And next is Kirin. Hey everyone, I'm Kirin. Happy to be here. So this is just how you're going to show up on the show this time, right, Kitty? Apparently so. Congratulations on your 10th year of Playism, and thanks everyone for all the congratulatory comments.
ハッシュタグプレイズムゲームショーでツイートしてくださった方の中から抽選でなんとプレイズムタイトルのパッケージ版セット1名様にプレゼントいたします。ですのでぜひ皆様ハッシュタグプレイズムゲームショー、
We're running a special campaign right now. If you tweet with the hashtag playism game show, you could win a set of package versions of playism games.And this is the kind of stuff that we've got in the package. Basically, a whole bunch of stuff to give out. Here's a game that came out around 2016, which honestly I can't pronounce. We've got the PS4 version. It also came out on the PS Vita.Basically, we bugged the hell out of Sony to get them to let us do the package version of this one.
15ホームランかな。
はい。
出してきて、で今回全部渡せるものは出そうと思って。
We've got a pretty good number of package versions of some of our games, and basically, to the winner, we're going to pass on whatever package games we're able to. Carol Blaster, Momodora, got a bunch of stuff here.There's this big ass one here, Lamalana 1 and 2, as a set. It also includes a strategy guide for both games. We've got Godfall for the PS5. A couple random soundtracks. We've also got a special book, it's a limited edition of.Basically, it's a bunch of info about the game Valhalla by Skibun Games.
今まで出した物理版をプレゼントしたいなと思います、はい、
キリンさんの動きが激しい。
キリンさんの動きが激しい。
これもらえるよ。死んじゃったけど。
Okay, looks like he died momentarily, but he's back.
こちらではセットで、ね、プレゼントを、ね、1名様に当たるということで、
ぜひツイートいただければ。
So yeah, tweet out with the Playism Game Show hashtag and you just might win this big old mess of package Playism titles.Alright, so here's some of the stuff we're going to be going over today. The 10th anniversary commemorative Nintendo Switch title sale info, Steam title sale info, indie game title, newest info on upcoming indie game titles, and some announcements for stuff that we're going to be doing in the future.
10年前インディーゲームって
So again, this is Playism's 10th anniversary. To touch a bit on that, about 10 years ago in Japan, indie games just weren't really all that popular or even well known. There were a lot of people overseas who had been saying, you know, I really want to check out some of these Japanese indie games, I want to play this, I want to try this. And we decided, okay, well, let's try and localize some of these games into English and publish them. We've put some of the games on PC, some of the games on consoles. Basically, we've been spending 10 years just doing whatever we can to try and up indie games as well as we can.
いわゆるインディーゲームがね上位ランキングに入ってたりするのですごい。
You know, 10 years later now, we're at the point where sometimes you see like indie titles pop up in like the you know, the top 10 recent games, top 10 sales, stuff like that. So indie games, just as a whole market and scene have really evolved over the past 10 years.
よく生き残れたなと。
And to be honest, I'm kind of surprised that we were actually able to survive for this whole 10 years. And basically, we've got nothing but thanks and appreciation for both the developers and the players, because of whom we were able to survive, to keep going this past whole 10 years. So we wanted to do some sort of event to thank everyone for all their cooperation and stuff, but since we can't really do stuff in person right now, we decided to do this kind of online event. So Gachiman, you've been doing Let's Plays for years. How have things changed in 10 years?
Indie gameチームっていう呼び方ではなくて、まだ個人開発の、なんだろう、まだお金を取ってないフリーホラーとか。
10 years ago, a lot of the games weren't even known as indie games. They were just known as like, you know, free horror games and stuff like that.
ものがインディーズゲームっていうふうに言われるようになったので、
And gradually these games that just, you know, random dudes are making on their own came to be known in Japan as well as indie games.
インディーゲームという呼称がまだ全然一般的ではなかったです。
Yeah, 10 years ago the term indie game wasn't even really in the public lexicon as far as Japan goes.
配信も今ほどね、
そうですね、お二人は走りですもんね、実況の最初からやってるんですもんね。
And these two dudes are two of the first live streamers or let's players to really come onto the scene. Like these two dudes have been around since forever, so they know what they're talking about.
私は実況以前からもいっぱいゲームやってますけど、10年前からもうすでにインディーは触ってるんですけど、これは
I mean, I've been playing games for years, like since, you know, before I started doing Let's Plays and stuff, but 10 years ago, I think I probably had already played some indie games, but I wasn't really aware of them as indie games. I wasn't really aware of that term. I didn't really think of them that way. It's great how far the indie scene and indie games in general have come over these past 10 years.
そうですね。まあ何をもってインディーかというのはね、本当にますます今10年経ってわけわからない感じになってきてますけどね。
なんでしょう、でもインディーにちょっとこうなんか愛がこもっているというか。
そうですね、やっぱりなんか特別なね、ゲームだなっていうの
は。 Yeah, it feels kind of like indie games. They're kind of special in that they have a little bit of extra love put into them.
そうなるように頑張ってきたので、
はい、すごく良い意味でのインディーを私は感じておりまして。
Yeah, I feel that the term indie is actually a really positive thing. So anyway, let's go into some of the campaign info for the Playasm 10th anniversary.
はい、 Nintendo Switch、 Nintendo eShop に
Right from May 13th till the 26th on the Nintendo eShop. We're going to be holding a sale on some selected Playasm games, which you can get for up to 80% off. There's 24 titles on sale, so yeah, be sure to check them out. Are there any particular titles that you guys are really into yourselves?
インディーズゲームってその、とりあえずそのパッケージ見たら、
はい、
端から買っちゃいますよね。
わかり
ました。食べ込んじゃいますよね。
そうですね。なんか本当になんかまずプレイする前にインディーゲームお買い物が楽しいってありますよね。
そうですね、もう。
Yeah, actually shopping for indie games is kind of almost as fun as playing them, you know? Looking at the different packages and just putting all this stuff in your cart and seeing all this stuff that you're planning on buying, it's just kind of fun. They're cheap too, which is nice. Sometimes, like, since they're so cheap, you end up buying so many of them that you end up not being able to play all of them, so you gotta watch out for that.
そこに向けてね、またこう買いだめではないですけれども、
溜まっていくんですね。
はい、本当にねお買い得になっているので、私ももうまあこれね、まだ今番組中なんで買えませんけど、帰ったら、
right, we're still doing the show right now at the moment, so I'm not going to buy anything right now, but as soon as I get home, I'm going to buy a whole load of these games. So, Mr. Mizutani, you've got a couple titles in particular that you'd like to recommend? We've got a lot of awesome titles, but if I had to choose a couple of them, then I'll pick some of the, we're going to show some of the ones that I think really kind of stand out.
多いですね。これカエルが主人公のアクションゲームなんですけど、
Alright, this is an action game in which the main character is a frog.
毒素物語と呼ばれるタイトルがありまして、毒素物語っていうのはまあそれこそフリーゲームなんですけど、あの毒素物語がそもそもインディーゲームの最初のゲームともまあ呼ばれているようなタイトルで。
This is a game that sort of sprouted out of one of the very first indie games to actually be called an indie game. This is by Studio Pixel. I can't remember if he's actually mentioned it specifically or not yet, but it's called Carol Blaster.
あと、まあ、カエルが主人公というところからちょっとまあ不思議な世界なんですけど、まあ、なんかちょっと社会を批判するじゃないですけど、ちょっと批評する。
It's kind of a really funky, really unique game where, I mean, just the fact that the main character is a frog is, you know, kind of funny itself, but the game actually, it's really sort of a commentary on modern day society and, you know, working life and stuff. The studio who created it uses a lot of really unique expressions in their games, both dialogue-wise and art-wise. And this is one of the indie games that I would definitely like to have as many people as possible check out. This one's available right now for 60% off the Nintendo eShop, which, as you can see, is hella cheap. So, by all means, grab it. It's a real old school, probably made action game.
ね、でこちらのケロブラスターなんですけれども、あのこちらですね、作者の開発室ピクセルの天谷大輔さんよりご覧の皆様への紹介メッセージ届いています。
So we've got a message from developer Daisuke Amaya regarding the game.
ブラスターで敵を蹴散らして集めたお金で武器を強化できる本当にシンプルな。
So this is a game where you run around blasting enemies with your gun, collecting money in order to power up your weapons. It's a pretty simple old schoolaction game. It's made of 7 stages, and there are also some secret hidden stages as well. If you're into side-scrolling action games, I'm pretty sure you're going to dig this game. Again, if you're into action games, I really think that you're going to dig this, so by all means, please go ahead and check it out. Yeah, it's actually super hard, and to be honest, to this day, I still haven't actually cleared the game. And you can actually clear the game three times. And once you clear the game three times, then you're able to access the hidden stages, which are just like stupid difficult.Like in a good way. It's fun. Try the game.
ちょっとこう変わった視点から世界を描かれてるっておっしゃってたので、
そうなんですよ。ちょっとまあもうだいぶ経ってるんですけど、なんかちょっとブラ企業に勤めるカエルなんですね。
はい。
会社に勤めてるサラリーマン。
It's kind of a weird story. It's about a salaryman frog who works for a really dodgy company.
おそらくバグ取りをするのが仕事なんですよ。っていうのをやってて、まあ、サラリーマンがブラック企業というか、はい、凄まじい労働に耐えながら戦う、はい、
So basically it's the story of a salaryman who works for a really messed up company who is just, he's just trying to get through the day. He's just trying to survive, and he's actually on a company trip while he's doing all this, you know, killing people stuff. So it really is a really unique and kind of funky game.But yeah, this frog is actually on the job while he's running around blasting people with flamethrowers and whatnot.
Alright,
we've got a couple more titles that we'd like to recommend, so let's move on to those. Carol Blaster was a Japanese title, but now we've got a title from overseas. This one is Night in the Woods by a studio known as Infinite Fall from the US.
これ田舎町のポッサムスプリングっていう町が舞台なんですけど、にあの大学中退して失意の元帰ってきて、
The main character is a cat. Her name is May, and basically she drops out of college and comes back to her hometown. She's kind of messed up in the head. She's got a lot of stuff she's dealing with. She meets up with some of her old friends from back in the day, and basically, yeah, her and her friends, they're kind of messed up. Like, she's, you know, she dropped out of college. She's not exactly, she's not a bad person or anything, but she does stuff like shoplifting and, you know, just kind of selfish and stuff. Basically, it's a story of her dealing with a whole variety of problems that she's got. She meets up with some of her old friends from, you know, high school, junior high, and has some issues with them. One of her friends is like, you know, why did you even bother going to college if you're just going to quit and come back? And she's like, well, hey, you had the money to go and you didn't bother going. I had no money to go. You know, I tried as hard as I could to be able to go to college, and I went. It didn't work out. You know, who are you to judge me? It's really sort of realistic and personal stuff like that. This is a game where there's lots of different twists in the story and lots of different sort of branching storylines. You basically control May as she walks around her hometown, you know, just lives her everyday life, hangs out with her friends, discusses issues and stuff. There's also some other parts of the game too, which are more, I guess, a little bit more funky. There's some music-based parts of the game. There's some dream sequences and stuff. This is basically the kind of game where you play it, or where I played it, and I was like, wow, I never even realized that you could express these kinds of feelings and these kinds of ideas and emotions in a game. It's an extremely expressive and emotional game. And yeah, right now it's available for 30% off. And this is definitely one of the games that I would like to get as many people as possible to try out, because it's just an amazing game.
よく言う言葉なんですけど、こういうのでいいんだよっていうタイトルですよね。そうそうそうそう、こういうのっていうタイトルな感じだと思うので、本来の、まあ、ゲームだなというふうに思いました。
そうですね、本当にゲームで原点ですよね。
で本当に、はい、原点ですよね、うん、
This is the kind of game where the graphics aren't like, you know, amazingly like revolutionary or anything. It's the kind of game where I want to show people and be like, this is okay. You know, if you're going to make an indie game, graphics wise, you can go for this. It doesn't have to be like, you know, amazing like AAA graphics and stuff. It looks good. But most importantly, it plays well. That's the important part of an indie game. That's basically a breakdown of what this dude's saying right now. But yeah, I feel this game is really well made. The graphics aren't extremely complex or anything, but they're just beautiful, really.
あんまりなんでしょうね、ゲームでこういうことを表現した人がいなかった。だなっていうのが感じられて、ゲームってこんなことしていいんだみたいな、はい、そういう可能性を感じる。
Yeah, it's a really personal and emotional game. And again, I kind of felt that, I kind of felt it was extremely unique, and that I never even thought that there are people out there making games, trying to express the kind of stuff that Night in the Woods expresses. So this is definitely one of the games I'd like to have everyone check out. We've got a few more games. Here goes the next one. Next one. And we've got some info about some Playism titles up on the Steam store. Until May 22nd, over 100 titles are available on sale for up to 80% off. I've actually got all these titles myself. So, Kirin, you really like plays and games. You pretty much just buy all of them, right?
ほぼプレイされてる。
じゃあほぼおすすめできますね、全部ね。
そうですね、
全部おすすめします。
ですね。
So basically, Kirin has played all these games and he recommends all of them. So thanks a lot, Kirin.
かもしれませんね。この並びで、では、
basically all these games that are available on sale, there's no misses here.
そうですね、まあ100タイトル以上あって、これも選ぶのはあれなんですけど、まあこちらのタイトル。 ご覧ください。
So it's pretty difficult to choose, you know, just a handful of titles out of over 100, but here's a couple that we really wanted to recommend.
プレズムゲームショーで取り上げたと思うんですけど、
はい、First one is the Casebook of Arnhem. 海外
版を含めたローカライズ版を Steam で展開しております。吸血鬼と吸血鬼オタクの女の子のタッグの、はい、まあ、探偵。
This is basically a game about a vampire and a sort of vampire otaku girl who are something sort of like private investigators.
本格的な推理ものになっていて、結構しっかり遊べるタイトルになっています。で、DLC
It's a really well made and thoroughly made mystery game.
9月以降からもう1個増やしてっていう形でやってるので、まあ続きも楽しみにしながら今回、セール中なのでお手に取っていただけると、
We're actually going to be adding some DLC to the game from around September. So leading up to that, we hope that lots of people will check out the game and look forward to the continuation. The music is also really good.
春紫さんから視聴者のご覧、ね、皆様へちょっとゲームの紹介メッセージ
を。We've got a message from the developer of the Casebook of Arnhem.
コミックミステリーをゲームでやっている作品です。かつて最強と恐れられた吸血鬼であり、今は
It's basically a proper mystery novel in the form of a game.
吸血鬼オタクの人間の少女リン・ラインバイスの二人が事件
を取ります。It's about a vampire named Arne.
人狼やゾンビなど様々な人外が
登場する世界で、現実世界では見かけない能力や異世界設定が登場してきて、このミステリーのように真相を当てるのは、they investigate various mysteries and incidents and stuff in a world filled with lots of weird characters, supernatural people and powers and stuff like that. If you're into this sort of thing, then this is definitely up your alley. So please, by all means, check it out.
ですね。
ですね。バカゲーム、はい、ゲームマガジンという取り組みがあって、そこで、ゲームをまあ連載するという仕組みで、はい、インディーゲーム作られてる、まあ、会社さんとか取り組みがあって、でそこが殺戮の天使でアニメにもなったタイトルなんですけど、はい、とか飛躍。
So there's a company called Vaka who has a this system called Vaka Game Magazine where they basically release various indie games. Some of their games, for example, Angels of Death have been made into anime versions. There's also lots of other games on the service such as Noel, The Mortal Fate. This is one of the games to check out if you're into some of those other titles. So let's move on to the next one. Next is Unholy Heights.
看板タイトルの一つでして、はい、EC サイトやってた頃に、
This is basically one of our first titles.
サイトが壊れる。
It actually sold so well that our site broke down several times.
アクセスできなくなって、サーバーを増強したら、3日後にまた落ちてみたいな。3段階ぐらいアップしないと。
We released the game within like hours. The server basically overloaded and shut down. 3 days later, after we finally got it fixed, it shut down again. That's how popular the game was. Basically, it's a game where you're the landlord of an apartment building in which various monsters reside, and you've got to deal with the different issues of these different monsters and people and the issues they have among each other and stuff like that. And you can develop the building, make it bigger, you know, add stuff onto it, renovate it. The tenants can like get married and like have kids and increase the number of tenants and stuff like that. It's a really unique and funky game about being a landlord for supernatural characters and demons, basically. It's crazy. Check it out.
すごい想像力豊かなゲームですね。めちゃくちゃ面白い。
はい、
今グノーシアっていうゲームが結構人気ですけど、はい、それのデベロッパーの前作になりますので、
はい、
There's a game that we're publishing right now called Gnosia, and this was actually the previous title of the same developer, of the developer of Gnosia. This is just like stupid cheap right now. It's available for 40% off, so basically just a bit over $2. This is one of the games that Kieran himself has been recommending, so by all means check it out.
その開発のプチデボートさんよりまたメッセージいただいております。お伝えします。
We've got a message from Pucci di Porto, the developers of Unholy Heights.
そして入居者に家賃を踏み倒されて逃げられたことがありまして、開発の方がね。
Before I started developing games, I actually worked as an assistant to a landlord, and there were times when our tenants would just refuse to pay rent and just disappear and basically escape. And that's what kind of gave me the idea to make this game about running an apartment full of monsters and weirdos and stuff.
そうですね、家賃が取れなくて悔しかった言ってましたね。はい。
So yeah, getting screwed over on rent was basically the, like in real life, was basically the idea, the basis of the idea for this game.
ぜひじゃこちらはね、もう238円なので、もう皆様の目でお確かめください。
So man, again, it's like less than $3, so again, by all means, check out the game if you're into any of this kind of stuff at all, it's really good. And the third game is Pixel Game Maker NV. So obviously, you know, we publish and sell indie games, but this is actually a tool for creating indie games. Technically, it's supposed to be for creating action games, but realistically, you can make pretty much almost any genre of game you can think of using Pixel Game Maker NV.
クオリティも上がっていて、これを買うと今すぐインディーゲームクリエイターになりますので、今 67% オフなので、
Put really simply, buy this, get a bit used to it, and you too can become an indie developer within days. This is available right now for 67% off, basically just under $40. This too is just stupid cheap. So if you've got even the slightest bit of interest in creating your own indie games, by all means.Check it out, learn the software, and start creating games, man.
視聴者の方へまたメッセージ届いております。アクションゲーム作る MV はプログラミングなしアクションを進め、シューティングやパズルなど様々なゲーム作りを楽しめるツールです。今回のアップデートで誰でも
This is a tool that allows you to make action games, shooting games, puzzle games, any kind of games with zero puzzling experience. Also, From here on out, the games that you create using Pixel Game Maker MV, you'll be able to publish and sell these games on the Switch shop.
今週までゲームを出してみたいという方におすすめのツールです。ぜひお確かめ、お試しください。
So if you've ever wanted to make your own game, but you don't feel like learning programming or it seems too hard, then this is definitely the software for you.
で、スイッチで動きますよみたいなんで、あれが今日アップデートで一般公開されて、一応作ったゲームをスイッチの方に、ま、申請ページみたいなのに飛べるようになってるんで、はい、一般の方でもスイッチの方に販売する手続きが今日からできるようになるという形になるので、
すごい。
はい。
So yeah, from today on, games that you've created using Pixel Game Maker MV, you're now able to register those with the Switch eShop and publish and actually sell your games on the Nintendo eShop. So that's one of the big draws of this software.
多くの方にもいいんですけど、うちわとかでなんか本当好きなもの作って家族で楽しむとかも。あ、そうですね。
変なゲーム作って友達に送ったりしてほしい
です。そういいですよね。なんかよく俺の作った曲だみたいな感じ。
You don't actually have to publish your games, you know, put them out there for everybody. By all means, just pick up the software, make some really weird ass games, some crazy stuff, and just share it with your friends and stuff. You know, that's completely fine as well. We just want to get as many people making their own personal games as possible. So feel free to use it however you want. The fourth title we'd like to introduce today is Tasomachi Behind the Twilight. This was just released recently, but seeing as how this is our 10th anniversary, I sort of begged the developers to let us put this on sale. So it's on sale for 20% off right now. To the devs, sorry for that, but that's how it goes. It was made by a developer named Nocras.He basically wanted to make a game out of the various art that he'd created, and that's what he made. It's similar to titles like Journey. Basically, it's a game where you can just really sort of chill and explore, don't have to worry about getting killed and murdered and stuff like that. It's a really nice, chill, relaxing exploration game. So, This one as well, by all means. If this is your thing at all, then go ahead and check it out.
あのような形でちょっとね参加していただいているのでよかったです。で、ではですね、まあ、引き続きこちらの黄昏に眠る街ちょっとあのですねご紹介いたしますと、制作者のノクラスさんからまたメッセージいただいております。
And we've got a message from developer Nocras.
絵の世界を自由に探索することを目的として、自らが個人で開発したアドベンチャーゲームです。プレイヤーは少女旅行
の This is a game that Nocras made on his own, just wanting to allow players to freely and to freely explore the artistic world that he's created. And that's pretty much what the game is. It was made with it was made by a developer named Nocras, who is an illustrator, and Ujiko, who is the who is in charge of the music. Basically, it's just it's a beautiful, fun, relaxing game. And again, if this is at all if this at all looks like it's it, would, it might be your thing, then definitely go ahead and check it out because we're pretty confident that you're gonna dig it.
コカラちゃん、
そうつい
つい、ネズ族ね、
そう、はい、ネズ族、移動中にちょっと蹴っ飛ばしがちな、
そうなんですよ、蹴っちゃうんですよね、ちっちゃいから蹴っちゃうんですよ、
ね、ぜひぜひこちら、
はい、
お楽しみください、
はい、
さあセール情報は以上と、まあたくさんねあのセール作品はあるんですけれども、
そうですね、はい、あとあの、
Alright, so we've got a whole bunch of games on sale right now,
Xbox ですね、
on both the Steam shop, and the Switch eShop, we've also got a bunch of sale, titles on sale right now on the Xbox store as well.
チェックいただけるといいかなと思います。あのブライトメモリーとかね、ホールナナイツとか。
For example, Bright Memory, Toho Luna Knights, Orange Blood, Giraffe and Anika. We've got a bunch of games on sale on all three of these stores. So yeah, please be sure to check them out. So that about wraps it up for the 10th anniversary sale information corner. Alright, now we're going to go on and introduce a couple indie games that Playism would like to recommend for everyone. Here's some stuff that's either out or coming out soon. Check them out. The first title we are going to introduce today is Umurangi Generation. This is made by an indie dev from New Zealand. Basically, it's a game in which you take photos in a really shitty future where the world is about to end. So again, the world is about to end. It's a really shitty future. The player is supposed to take different photos of this messed up ass world.
どうもこの世界はちょっとまともではないというか、普通ではないというか、何か危機が迫っていて、まあ、空も赤くて、ウムランギって赤い空。
Actually, Umurangi means red sky. And you can see in this game that the world is basically kind of messed up. It's put really simply, it's a really artistic title. With a lot of really cool stuff in it, artistically and aesthetically, it's just a really beautiful title. There was some DLC released last year.
And
this year it was actually nominated for three awards at the Indie Games Festival this year. It's a title that's really proven popular throughout the world, and it will be on sale. It will be available on the Nintendo Switch from June 5th. So this is another title that we'd love to have you check it out if you're even the slightest bit interested.
多分ね、キリンさんはね、こうゲーム実況を通してメッセージを伝える人だからね。
シャイですね。
私がとっさに振っちゃってごめんなさいね。
すみません、さっきから
緊張して。Yeah, Kieran, sorry for just asking you questions like that all of a sudden.
あれですよね、なんかお食事と睡眠しか取れなかったみたいなことね、ツイッターかな
り。あ、そうですね。
すみません。
Yeah, but I'm a bit nervous and haven't slept much recently, so sorry about that. Anyway, this is a wonderful game, so again, by all means, please go ahead and check it out. And once again, we've got a message from the developers of Umurangi Generation.
Umurangi Generation's game system is to use a camera to teach the younger sister a picture of her
inspired by the main system of the main game system of Umurangi Generation was inspired by my teaching my younger cousin how to use the camera.
その喜びを体験してもらいたいと思います。私と作曲家であるソーハイヒールズは、
I watched him taking pictures and then putting those together and editing them to make his own kind of special thing, and that inspired me to make the game.
興味を持っていただけると幸いです。特にブレステ2とゲーム機の
I'd like it if I could get the players to play the game and have the same sort of experience for themselves.
ガッチマさんいかがですか？
そうですね。だからもう。
The game is actually artistically inspired by games like Jet Set Radio from the early 2000s from the PS2 era. So I feel that fans of the PS2 and GameCube era will particularly dig this game, so please check it out. What do you think, Gatchimon? Yeah, I think the theme is pretty cool. You know, there's evil and you have to like defeat that evil. It's not that simple of a game. It's a game that sort of makes a game out of the culture of modern gaming itself. So yeah, it's a really unique and cool game that I'd like everyone to check out.
破滅が迫るクソみたいな未来ですか？
Also, since we're sort of in the middle of the corona pandemic right now, this game sort of matches with the whole pandemic vibe of not being able to like meet up directly with and connect with other people and stuff. So it's kind of a coincidence, but yeah, this game sort of matches with the whole vibe of the times of this, you know, the pandemic and not being able to get really close to people physically and stuff. I feel like maybe that's also got something to do with the fact that the game was really highly rated by a lot of players recently. But I feel that right now is exactly kind of the best time to check out this game.
ぜひね、こちら皆様、ね、プレイして、はい、購入してみてください。そしてまだまだございます。はい、こちら続きましてご覧ください。
Hey, get out of my way!
Knights and Bikes, available on the Nintendo Switch, PS4, and on Steam.
こちらご紹介するタイトルは、
Once again, it's Knights and Bikes.
そして、それでは、
Let's talk to Mr. Mizutani about the game itself.
そうだって、イギリスのデベロッパー、リトルビッグプラネットとか、名だたるタイトルやってたベテランのデベロッパーが作って、
This is a game by an English developer who has worked on Little Big Planet and a slew of all other games. Basically, it's about a dude riding a bike, and him and his friend hang out and play together, and everything just kind of starts snowballing from there. It's about two friends who kind of explore the friendship between each other and search for like treasures and stuff like that. It's basically an adventure heavy action adventure type game. We've showed this off on previous streams and shows. It's not exactly just about ready, but it'll be ready for release really soon. Basically, it's going to be released sometime this summer.
ヨンダってローカライズ担当に強く言われて、うん、そうなんだねって言って、
それで自転車で、ね、
自転車
だ
からこだわりがある、うん、うちの担当のこだわりが、
there's some stuff about the Japanese title that makes no sense in English, so I'm not going to bother interpreting that.
伝わってきましたね。で、あ、2人でも協力プレイ。
This is a game that can be played by either one person, or you can play with, together with a friend and play sort of co-op play.
これって今思ったんですけど、自伝とかけてるとかそういうことではない？
わあ、どうなんやろ、ね、ちょっと。
And there's some more stuff about the localized Japanese title that makes no sense in English, so we're gonna skip over that.
いただいて、すみません、また余計なこと。
Trust me, it was fun.
自転車ナイツ、はい、ご紹介いたします。
All right, so that was Knights and Bikes.
そして続きましては、Our next title is this one.
Legal Dungeon.
紹介するタイトルはリーガルダンジョン。
All right, and this is our next title, Legal Dungeon.
やったって方もね、たくさんいらして。ありがとうございます。では水谷さんに改めてね、ちょっと伺いましょう。
はい、韓国のソミさんっていうデベロッパーさんが作られたタイトルで、はい、まあ、警察になって。
This is by a South Korean developer named Somi.
被疑者を、まあ、有罪にとして、まあ、提出する。
This is a game in which you work for the police. And basically you're writing up a notebook about the various crimes and incidents that you're investigating. You have to create the various documents required to either prosecute or decide to not prosecute each individual case.There's a whole bunch of endings that you can reach at the end of the game. Basically, once you reach the ending, everything sort of comes together and makes sense. It's a sort of 3D artist, 3D art style mystery game. This was released for the Switch this February. It's a game full of text, so.Unless you get really into it, it's sort of hard to really get into it. But it's the kind of game that it's really kind of difficult for just your average player to get into. But it actually ended up selling a lot of copies. And so we decided to release the game for not only Steam, but for PlayStation 4 and Xbox One as well. And these two versions will be released sometime this year.
なんかいろんなゲームやりてえなって思って見てるだけなんですけど。
見る人だって。
Curious what to think about this game.
ゲームする人ですもんね、そもそもね。
そうなんです。いや、まあ、
リーグ。I've watched all these different games and you know I've basically played most of them, but
じっくり。読める読み物として
Legal Dungeon is a bit hard to get used to and to learn.
よろしくお願いいたします。
そうですね。
But it's the kind of game that you can really enjoy as a, as more of like a novel than just a regular game. So I'll be looking forward to playing that.
こちらも Legal Dungeon の作者のソミさんよりご覧の皆様へのメッセージねいただいております。
And once again, we've got a message for everyone from Somi, the developer of Legal Dungeon. This game was born from the guilt that I felt doing my actual job in real life. That's kind of dark.
無実の容疑者を拷問したり虐待したりしていました。あの事件から10年以上が経ちましたが、問題の主な原因が解決されたとは思います。
In the year 2010, it was found that the South Korean police, in order to get confessions from suspects for various crimes, they were found to have been having, coercing and even torturing people into admitting to crimes. There were a lot of crimes that were thus considered to be wrapped up and closed, but I just felt that that wasn't right. And so I decided to make that into a game. And in this game, you act as a police officer, a police detective, and it really sort of makes you think about the sort of work that the police are doing and the sort of investigations that they work on.
ビターに聞いてくるのかなっていう、
は
い、
素晴らしいタイトルです。
こちらはね、ぜひ皆様まだね未プレイの方はね、はい、お試しください、はい。社会派ですね。
社会派です。はい、社会派です。
そうですね、社会派です。
社会派です。
社会派です。社会派になりたい方ぜひ。さあ続きましてはこちらの映像をご覧ください。こちら紹介するタイトルレプリカですね、はい、こちらもねちょっと前回もお伝えはしましたが、ね、改めて水谷さんに、はい、
先ほどのリーガルダンジョンと同じデベロッパーさんのタイトルで、はい、こっちは他人のスマホをいじるゲームなんですけど、はい、他人のスマホをいじってこの持ち物持ち主がどういう人なのかみたいなのをまあ見ていくとで、まあ、これも警察というか国家というか、まあ、社会派ゲームなんですけど
社会派です
ね社会派なんですよ、まあ、こいつが犯罪行為を犯してないかみたいなのをまあチェックしていくっていうのがまあ見ていくタイトルで、まあリーガルダンジョン PS4X やるならまあレプリカもやっちゃおうということで、レプリカの方も同時に開発を進めておりまして、まあ、こちらも年内早いうちだと思いますけど発売いたしますので、うん、まあ今までスイッチ、スチーム、スマホで出てるタイトルだと思いますけど、まあ、PS ユーザー、Xbox ユーザーの方にも触っていただけるといいかなと思います、
うんはい、すごいショーのね数々というか
そうですね、これは流行りましたね一時 ね、はいうん、
こちらもまたキリンさんがお好きそうと言いますか
好きですね、
はい、 ですよね。
でも実際自分のスマホ見られるのは嫌だなと思ってゲームだからいいかなと思って
あ、
欲しいです、はい、
そこまでそっか生々しく感じてしまう。
So this game feels really sort of real and kind of gritty, yeah? Yeah, the game feels really kind of super real and gritty. Like, you really feel kind of guilt like while you're playing, you know, like when you figure out somebody's password for their phone, you really feel kind of filthy, like you've actually hacked somebody's phone and you're kind of infringing on their privacy and stuff. So it's a really kind of real, kind of impacting game. Yeah, I mean, as long as you're having fun, then whatever. It's just a game.
こちらのね、またリーガルダンジョンと同じくソミさんから、
はい、
皆様へのメッセージをね頂戴しております。レプリカが発売されたのは韓国の大統領が弾劾される1年前でした。当時政府は多くの不正をして多くの人々が路上で政権にデモをしていました。でも私は何をすべきか分かりませんでした。その時自分はゲーム開発者だから開発者にしかできないことをやろうと思ったんです。もしソミの世界をまた見たい気分で隠れた宝石を見つけたいという方はぜひレプリカとリーガルダンジョンをプレイしてみてください。日本のプレイヤーと
出会う素晴らしい機会を与えてくれて心から感謝しております。And that is from where Replica and Legal Dungeon kind of came from.
重いです。
重いですね。
いや本当にいいんですよ、ソミさん。
ソミさんが
いいタイトルをね。
Yeah, Somi makes some really great titles.
この2つ、あとザ・ウェイクっていうもう一個あるんですけど、その3つがソミさんの罪悪感さん。
Yeah, Replica and Legal Dungeon are part of a trilogy of games by Somi called The Guilt Trilogy.
好きですね。
Check all those games out if you're in a really kind of gritty, dark, law and order and stuff.
多くの、ね、政府の不正とか。
結構なんかアーティストがすごい大統領なんか、はい、韓国の方で自由な表現をしにくい時期がなかった。
Yeah, Somi said that he felt it was becoming a really difficult time to speak freely in South Korea. So he decided to make a game sort of reflecting
that. リーガルダンジョンの絵を描いてもらったのと日本語訳を描いてもらったのがグノーシャのプチレポとメゾノマを作った人なんですけど、はい、その人とお話とインタビューをさせてもらったんですけど、リーガルダンジョンリリースにあたってで、やっぱりこれだけの物語を、うん、
Yeah, we did an interview with the Pucci Deboto developers of Unholy Heights and Gnosia between them and Somi. And the Pucci Deboto developers are saying, wow, like I wonder if like a Japanese developer would actually be able to create this sort of really deep and, you know, heavily intertwined story like that. Like, this is something really awesome and original. I've never seen something like this before. And yeah, I kind of agree. I feel that this is a story that kind of had to have been made from a certain person in a certain country and culture in order to come out the way that it came out. So, right, so that's all for Replica. And next up, we've got Mighty Goose. Yeah, so the vibe kind of swapped out a bit there between Legal Dungeon and Mighty Goose.
そうですね。前回の放送でも取り上げさせていただいて、いろいろ僕もインディーゲームいっぱい見てきて、でも結局ガチョウになっていろんなものを壊すのが一番楽しい。
I've played a lot of indie games throughout my life, a lot of indie action games. But as far as games where you become a goose and just go like wreck a bunch of shit.This is definitely the best title in that genre I've played so far, so we decided absolutely we want to release this game. So this game will be getting a release on June 5th on Nintendo Switch, Xbox One, and PS5, and it's going to be released everywhere all at once. So we got that going for us.
一応これで実現できたということで、はい、マイティーゴーストドットのねゲームを PS5 で、
おーそうですね、
本当これ面白い、
PS5、そうです
ね、マイティーゴースト is a seriously funny game、
すごい精密なプラットフォーマーというか今流行ってるんですけど、
It's kind of popular as like a properly like well made platformer kind of like Celeste or something like that.
これは
it's a bit more rough around the edges.
もっと荒いというか、やられる前にやるみたいな。
It's a bit like overdone. It's really like
壊しまくって楽しいみたいな。
Western style.
You get a lot of
pleasure and fun just from blowing shit up and like shooting lots of shit and stuff. It's that kind of game, in a good way. Actually, the release date is the day before Gachiman's birthday.
ありがとうございます。そうですね。じゃあお誕生日に買ってもらおうかなと思いますね。
どなたかに巻いていく。
そうですね。買っていただこうかなと思います。
Congratulations, homie. You're getting a free copy of Mighty Goose.
いや、本当こういうのがいいんだよ。本当に。
まさにもうだって。始まったらすぐ遊べるじゃないですか、こういうゲーム
が。Yeah, I like this kind of game. This is the kind of game you can start and get like right into.
確かに。
Just jump in without thinking about anything and just start wrecking shit.
そう。
逆に斬新ですね。
It's kind of calming in a way. Like, you know what's expected of you, you know what to expect. It's just something fun to jump into and like mess stuff up.
いいですけども、やっぱその長いチュートリアルがあってやっと始まるんじゃなくて、もうすぐにパーって、じゃあ撃って倒せっていうのはやっぱいいですよね。
Yeah, basically, it's just super fun for people who just want to get in and kick a bunch of ass.
いいですね。確かにすぐ遊べるというか。
Load up Mighty Goose and just kick ass for days.
何もそこまで
言ってるんですか。本当楽しい。素晴らしいですね。
確かにすぐ楽しみたいみたいな気持ちの時にね、こちらぜひ。で、Mighty Goose、こちらも開発の
ブラストモードさんより Mighty Goose has a message for everyone.
It's a running gun game in which a goose is the main character.
Basically, you're going to use a bunch of weapons to take out a bunch of other bad dudes with a bunch of weapons.
この任務を果たすためにプレイヤーは複数の武器や乗り物、共に戦うコンパニオンなどを駆使しないといけません。
Basically, it was a game that was originally born from a demo that I made as a joke. But as a developer, I realized, hey, this actually might be a pretty cool game. You know, having this goose being like a badass warrior. So I kind of took a bit farther, and it's turned into a full-on proper game with you know proper concepts. It's got twists in the stories. It's got well-written dialogue and you know humor and jokes and crap loads of action. It's the first game that we've released as Blast Mode, so we're a bit nervous about this, but.We put everything we can into the game to make sure that the players will be able to enjoy it as much as possible. So we're pretty confident that you guys are gonna like it. So please check out the game.
はい。すごいオランダのデベロッパーさんですけど、ものすごいいい人で。
The dude who made the game, he's a really cool guy.
気に入ってくれるかなって。
気に入ってほしいですね。はい。
We hope you dig the game.
お楽しみください。でこちらのマイティーグース実はですね完成版があるということで一足お先にキリンさんにゲーム実況をしていただきました。
We passed on to キリンto do a little to do put together a little let's play for us. So thanks for that, dude.
いえいえ。
で今回先月ながらプレイした映像をね収録してまいりました。
He actually he brought a clip from his let's play for us. So let's take a look, shall we?
マイティーグースやっていきましょうね。ごきげんよう、私です。今回はこのゲーム、2人で協力プレイができるということで、それを見せたいということで、プレイイズムからイズムくんをお迎えしております。よろしくお願いします、イズムくん。ね。ま、声は私しか聞こえないんだけど、イズムくん、もうやる気十分ということで、ね、よろしくお願いしますね。とりあえず、武器庫行って、事前にちょっと準備がねあるから、このコンパニオンを見まして、今んとここの2人しかいないんだけど、レギュラーダック、いつもそばにいてくれるバーク司令官、今回このバーク司令官でやってみるかね。このコンパニオンをこう装備するってことかな。そしたらミッション開始で まあ、イズム君とはね、よう2人で初めてゲームやるからね。試しに最初のステージやってみるか。かっこよく来ましたよ、グースト。ミッションスタート。バーク司令官。まあ、このステージは、今からこのバーク司令官を助けに行くんだけどね、実際は。これね、2P コープをね、オンにしないと 2P できないからね。よし、これで一緒に行けるぞ、イズム君。よろしく。お、ありがとう、イズム君。イズム君、操作とか大丈夫？ちょっと、攻撃してみて。よし、それで敵をバッコンバッコン殴っていくんだ。コントロールパネルがあるはずっす。これこのままじゃいけないからな。ちょっとそこ、その先を行ってみて。あ、イズム君、イズム君、ほんまに動けちゃうもんな、イベント中でも。まあね、イズム君はともかくさ、グースのこのね、爽快感はすごいぞ。うん、あ、タミヤのことぶっ壊してしまった。これでまあいけそう、いけそう感がありますな。イズム君行こうぜ。お、イズム君、イズム君、じゃあそっち任せるわ。やってる？お、やってるね。お、ボッコンボコンやってね、大将。その調子で痛い。もう、うん、まあ、イズム君のせいではないんだけども、イズム君、スーってきたね、今。ロケット搭載？これ、あれだね、コンパニオンと 1P で離れると、ワープしてくるんだね。じゃあ、こっちだ、イズム君。守ってもらわないと。私、命は私一つなんだから。あ、縦のやついるから、その後ろから、そう。お、いいよ。後ろから殴ってんね。あ、いいね。これがもう協力プレイの醍醐味よ。どい。下とか上とかにも向けて発射できる。イズム君？今、イベント中だから。今、敵の皆さんが、初めての、イズム君。いやこのスローになる演出いいよね。やったったって感じがして。燃えるぜグース。これだ、これパワーアップね。ゲージ溜まったら発動することができる。これこの時無敵だから。まあね、一定時間しかないんだけどね、もう終わったらもうグースがスンってなるわ。賢者タイム。あ、今のダメっすか。はい、さあ行こう。はーい。アタジャスキャニオとおじさますぐそばにいるみたいっすよ。うん、この辺りを探してみてください。気をつけてね。オッケー。そう、当初の目的忘れてたけど、まあ、だってここにいるもんね。このバークおじさん助けに来たんだよな。そういや、ガチョウが助かったわい。これがタタオサラじゃ。へへへ。あれ、ご兄弟の方ですか。どっちがイズム君？いや、まあどっちでもいいけど、じゃあ3人で行くか。ちょっとお願いしますよ、どっちのイズム君も。お、積極的に。お前もやんのかい。今イベント中だから。2人のイズム君、 NPC のイズム君、こいつがね結構強いんだよな。ちょっと私はね、あの敵の弾ちゃんと見極めて避けないと危ないぞ。これステージ1からもうすでに強敵。ごめんね、ここでゲームオーバーになったりしたらごめんね。今までは何回もね、ここでゲームオーバーになってるから。おバンバンやってって、ロケロランチャーよっこいしょ。左右のやつ倒してからだな。あとこの誘導ミサイルをこう誘導させて。これあれでしょ、イズム君自身もさ、動かしててどっちが自分かわからんくないでしょ。 いいんだ、とにかくやれ。3人で倒すんだ。やったぜ。グースが泣いた。ふう。どっち、ズム君？あ、ジャンプした方ね、今。よし、じゃあ行くぞ、イズム君。あれ、イズム君？必死に走ってついてきてるのがイズム君か。すまんね。これ NPC と私の2人用なんだ。これで降りたりもできる。あー、で、これマシンガンで、このマシンガンはもう、撃ち放題。これはいいですな。そしてかわいそうにイズム君徒歩、そしてイズム君は徒歩と。すまんね、これはもう爽快感だけを求めた結果、イズム君には釘を押し入れという。外だね。うん、トラクタービームスイッチオン。ちゃんと入りな、イズム君。よしよしよしよし。いやー、よかったよかった。ミッションコンプリート。お、ランク S ですって。いやー、2人で、いや3人で途中から頑張ったね。ありがとうございました。
面白いですね。
That's a bitch in game。
どなたというか、
まあ、うちの暇じゃないですけど、手が空いて
た。プレイズム君。途中でイズム君分裂しましたよね。
本来豚を助けに行くステージに豚を連れてきたので豚が2匹いる形になっちゃったんですけど、
なるほど、
あんまないパターンだったんですけど。
あ、そうか、レアケース、
はい、いやちょっとレアケースなんですけど、
はい、完全に戦車 で置いてってましたからね。
置いてってましたね。
どっちが。
There's a lot of crazy stuff going on in this game. Saving pigs, accompanying pigs to various locations, some secondary locations possibly, which we all know are the most dangerous kind of locations. Yeah, there's some crazy shit in this game that you really gotta play it to get it. It's a really great, fun, interesting game. So, by all means, check this out.
キリンさんはやっぱりゲームしてる方が生き生きしてますね。
ありがとうございます。
キリンにしてもビットモーラ
ー、やっぱりキリンさん
のゲームだ。ゲームがあれば喋れるんですけど、
Talky and happy when you're playing games, right? Yeah, I'm only really able to talk like when I'm playing games, sorry. So what do you think about the game Mighty Goose, Kirin?
いやー、本当に水谷さんもさっき言ってた通り、何もね考えずに攻撃もできて、
But just like 水谷 said a second ago, you don't really have to think a whole lot about it. You know, you just go around attacking stuff, blowing stuff up, kicking ass. And it's just like a whole lot of fun from the very beginning.
地面のボスからめっちゃ難しい。
But it also gets pretty difficult sometimes too with like all the, you know,So, all these attacks coming everywhere and...
最後の方本当に乗れなくて、あれイズム君っつって、まあこのまま行くかって。
But to break that down, it's hella fun and yeah, if you're a fan of Mighty Geese, then this is definitely up your alley.
なんでちゃんと乗れたんですか。いやでも確かにこう、これなんだろう、どうだろうっておっしゃいながらすごい楽しい。
Yeah, it's the kind of game where while you're playing it, you're going, what the hell is this? What's even going on? But you end up having fun.
いきなりでもなんか急に楽しいっていうのがすごく伝わってきましたね。
はい、ありましたね。ありがとうございます。
以上、ここまで前回紹介タイトルの続報をお届けいたしました。さて、最新情報はまだまだ続きます。お次はです ね、本放送が初出しとなるタイトル情報をご紹介してまいりましょう。まずはこちらをご覧ください。
Some more titles to toss out.
さあ、こちらご紹介するタイトルはラムラーナ 2DLC でございます。では水谷さん、お願いします。
ラムラーナというのはニゴロという開発
で作っているタイトルで、ラムラーナシリーズ、
ラムラさんという方が
ティームネームニゴロ、
ひっくり返すとラムラーナ。
The main designer of the game is a guy named Naramura, and when you flip his name around, it becomes Naramurana, which is where the name came from. It's pretty simple, really. This game was made around the same time as Carol Blaster, which we introduced earlier. And so basically, we handled the first two entries in the series, and a few years ago, they came to us and said, hey, we want to work on some DLC. We got some tools for it. We're going to start working on it now. That was about 3 or 4 years ago, and now this DLC is finally complete.
パズル要素が強いアクションゲームで、まあ、石碑の謎を解いたりして、
Basically, it's an action adventure game where you know, you've got to solve various mysteries and puzzles. You do stuff like you know, you have to move around certain statues in certain places and find certain texts and stuff like that in order to figure out both the story and like where you need to go. And this is kind of like a powered up version of the original Lama Lama games.Roided the hell out and angry at you. That's kind of the level of difficulty of this new DLC. So, get your magic underpants ready for this one.
So
basically, after you spend about 60 hours exploring the ruins in the previous game,After that, you've got this DLC, the Tower of Awanis, which it just makes, you know, it's going to be frustrating and infuriating and fun as hell. And it's just stupid difficult. But I mean, it's built for the kind of people who are into that kind of game. There was DLC before for the first entry in the series where a lot of people complained, like, I'll start the DLC and from the very beginning, I don't know where I'm supposed to go, I don't know how to enter the ruins and stuff. It's kind of like that. It's kind of like, wow, this is just ridiculously hard, why are you doing this to me type of game. For which the Nigoro team and Mr. Naramura himself are well known. And Naramura himself says, this is not for casual gamers, this is not for people who need strategy guides and stuff. Basically, this game is going to kick you in the teeth and slap your mom. So, get ready for some hardcore frustration, but the kind of frustration that's worth it in the end. It's the kind of game that once you clear one of the Lama Lama games, you can feel it. Like, yeah, this is the kind of game that's gonna live on as a legend. So yeah, if you haven't played the games yet, by all means, go get Lama Lama 1 and 2 off Steam, play the hell out of them, and get yourself all nice and buffed up for this latest DLC. And then have fun getting your ass handed to you over and over again in the latest DLC.
One が結構遺跡に入ると実績がもらえるんですけど、まあ一番最初の実績なんですけど、それがもう半分ぐらいしかいなくて、まずみんな遺跡に入れないっていうぐらいだったので、2はまず遺跡に入れるようにはしようとか、そのもうちょっととっつきやすくてもいいんじゃないかっていうのをいろいろ言って嫌だったんでしょうね。
So after the first game, we talked to the developers and we're like, okay, let's make it a little bit easier to jump into for the players. And so they did that. And apparently they didn't like having to do that. So they said, okay, you know what, screw you. We're going to make this DLC hella hard, so suck it. And that's pretty much how this DLC came to be. This is not the kind of DLC that's going to hold your hand and coddle you and tell you, okay, now go here and give you hints. This DLC is just going to beat the crap out of you.
はい、やりごたえのあるゲームです ね,
ですね、
はい、
いいですね。
でこちらのラムラナツ DLC ですが、ニゴロさんよりご覧の皆様メッセージ
を送ります。
ラムラーナシリーズは考古学的な謎解きがメインとなり、一風変わった探索アクションゲームです。ラムラーナは子供の頃に遊んだゲームがもっと長く遊べたらいいのにという思いで、思いつく限りの要素を詰め込みました。ラムラーナ2は そんなダブルアナをもっとやりたいのに。
We wish we could play the kind of games that we played when we were kids, but we wish we could play them longer and there was more stuff in them. They were harder. So they decided to make these games on their own. It's as simple as that. They played these adventure games, kind of Indiana Jones type games back when they were kids. Wanted them harder and longer, and yeah, they injected that indie Viagra into that idea and got their game longer and harder and the kind of game that just pounds ass. So they succeeded there. There's a lot of people who do like live streams of the Lama Lama games, but there aren't that many people who are actually to clear the game. They usually end up giving up partway through and saying, okay, screw this, like, I can't deal.
配信できる、特にそういうのが盛り上がってる今の時代って、みんなでじゃあなんか一緒に。
あ、そうです。去年このラムラーナ1、2ってボックスを出したんですけど、
ラムラーナ1、2ボ
ックス。この時に、コロナがちょうど始まって、はい、プロモーションやろうと思ってたイベントが全部なくなって、
right around then we were going to start doing some, we're going to start having some events, like, you know, real world events and stuff. And right around then was when this whole pandemic thing happened, so we were unable to do any of that. So we're like, well, what the hell are we going to do now? And so I just decided to do a bunch of, like, let's plays and stuff on my own. And so I just started doing a bunch of let's plays, like all these comments from people telling us, telling me stuff like, oh, hey, do this, don't do this, oh, hey, you shouldn't give away too much about this. And yeah, basically the people who are used to the game just pretty much refused to give any hints or help out, and everyone just kind of sat there watching me, waiting for me to screw up and like hurt myself. So that's the kind of game this is. It's kind of fun to watch other people struggle with it, you know. And if you do a live stream of any of these games, there's a really good chance that Mr. Naramura himself and some of the Nigoro staff will show up on your stream and toss you comments and hurt your feelings every once in a while and stuff. So, yeah, you might have an opportunity to speak directly with the devs if you do a let's play of these games. All right, next, let's check out this video.
こちらはですね、マニフォールドガーデンでして、はい、ではこちらまた水谷さんにね、ちょっと詳しくお伺いします。
はい、
Right, so that was Manifold Garden. So, Mizutani, can you tell us a bit about that?
幾何学的な世界とか、まあ、直線で描かれている世界で、重力を操ることができまして、
It's a game developed by an American studio called William Shear Studios.
壁側に重力をやるとか、天井に重力
をやるとか、It's kind of hard to explain, but basically you're able to control the flow of gravity.
3D 視点のパズルゲームで、あと特徴としては、
So you're able to like spin the environment around, like walk on walls and ceilings, and, you know, turn walls into floors, stuff like that.
世界があるみたいな、そういう永遠にとにかくずっと続いていく直線的な無機質な世界で、はい、パズルを解いていくっていうタイトル、すごく美しい。
And they're like these worlds like on straight lines that basically go on like forever. And if you fall off one of those worlds, you fall onto like a different world. And you can keep going, you know, left and right on that world. But there's this like infinite amount of worlds that you can like fall up and down to. Deals a lot with colors. You need to like sort of apply certain colors to certain parts of the game, which disappear and come back and stuff. Objects sort of
体験できる対
策で、generate from other objects in the in the vicinity in the game, turn into like birds and fly away and stuff. It's a really beautiful and kind of ethereal game. It's currently scheduled for release on May 20th.And we've actually got a package version of it available for the Nintendo Switch with some bonus swag in it as well. Some art done via a collaboration with a Japanese artist. So the package itself is sort of a work of art. We've also got a PS4 package version. And for the first run edition, you also receive the original soundtrack. And this kind of weird tape that goes on for days, that in a way kind of represents the infinite stretch of the worlds of the game, or something like that. So if you're really into game soundtracks, PS4 games, and tape, then this is probably the game for you.
のゲームが好きな方はそれの名作の一つなので、あのジャンル好きな方は。
It's a bit similar to some games like Subliminal and Anti-Chamber, stuff like that. People who like those kind of games are probably really going to dig this one.
ちょっとかギリギリわかるぐらいにちゃんとなってるので。The PS5 版が出る。
Yeah, the difficulty level is it's kind of just right. It's not like super hard or like hold your hand easy. It's kind of in between there. The PlayStation 5 version is also going to be released at the same time. For the PS5 version, you actually get some hints throughout gameplay to help you along.
Game which ついてまして、写真をすごい加工できるんで、アート作品のスクショが撮れるぐらいの。
There's a photo mode in the game where you can just go around different parts of the game and just taking all the different photos you like. So it's really fun for kind of creating your own art from a pre-developed game as well. It's kind of fun to collect like the most beautiful images you can find throughout the game and share them with your friends and whatnot.
Hi everyone.
And we've got a message from William Shearer Studios. So here we go.
Manifold Garden is a game that reimagines physics, space, and architecture. In the game,You have the ability to change gravity and walk on any surface. Any wall or ceiling can become the floor. In addition, the world in the game repeats itself infinitely. So not only is there not a single down direction, but you can actually go down in order to go up. Falling off a ledge brings you right back to where you started. If you're a little confused, don't worry. The game makes a lot more sense when you're playing it. The development team and I are absolutely thrilled that on May 20th,Manifold Garden is coming to Japan and Asia on Nintendo Switch, PlayStation 4, and PlayStation 5. We would also like to thank our partner PlayZone in helping us bring the game to you. This is actually our first time having the game in physical stores, and we are so excited. We can't wait for you to experience Manifold Garden for yourself. Thank you.
なんかモテそうなおしゃれな方でしたね。
That's English, so there you go. Yeah, he's a really cool guy. So, fashionable, good looking dude. Really nice guy. He's a pretty well known artist on top of a game developer, too. Alright, we've got some more stuff coming up. Next, check this out.
こちらは、はい、ブレイクアート2。
ブレイクアート2、ビューティー・インディストラクチ
ャー。水谷さんがまず伺いましょうか。
はい、マーキュリー・サイオっていう日本の開発者が作ってて、
マーキュリー・サイオなんですけど、ジャパニーズ・スタジオなんですけど、マーキュリー・スタジオ、
ブレイクアート2は、スチームで、basically a single dude。リリースされているタイトルなんですけど、バトルレーシング、
ブレイクアート2 has already been released on stream。
好きなロボットをカスタマイズして作って、
It's sort of like mech racing game where you make and customize your own robot。
打ち合ったりとか、
your own mech and you know put on all kinds of like weapons and tweak your stats and everything and you race and battle against other robots to try to win.
One があったんですね。で、もともとスマホのゲームだったんですけど、で、スマホのゲームでやってたのを、
Breakouts One was originally a smartphone game.
って聞いたら、スマホの性能の限界があったので、この限界を外した
And when we asked, okay, so what do you want to do for your next game? He said, well, I basically want to do what I did on the first game, but there are too many limitations to what the smartphones can do. So I want to bring this onto PC and PS4. I want to really like take advantage of the technology.So we've been porting it to Steam, PS4 and whatnot, and right now it's scheduled to be released sometime by the end of the year. It's really gorgeous, just really kind of like, in a good way, like overdone type game. We thought we'd actually be able to get it released a lot earlier, but it's just so much stuff going into this game and so many tweaks and adjustments and improvements made.It's really coming into complete form now, and it's just a super addictive, cool-looking, fun-ass game. So if you're into mechs and robots and racing and any of that stuff, definitely check this out. It's a badass title. It's really hard to make these kind of robots. They look cool, but they're also really easy to drive in a race. But this game basically nails that aspect.
で、なんか自分がこうゲームなのに G を受けてる感じの演技とかできるわけですね。速すぎるっていうの
まだ曲がれないんで。
地平道そう地平道を吐きながらこう曲がると
か。耐えきれない。
たまんないですねそのね。
体が耐えきれないんで。
Sometimes you find your mech just going too fast for you to handle, and it's kind of overwhelming. You're like, ah, I can't keep up with this. But that's actually kind of one of the fun parts of the game.
とかっていうので、戦略的にマシンを選んでとかっていうのが。
You can also play together with friends. Say, okay, I'm going to use this kind of machine with these features. You use this one with these features, and you know we're going to sort of work together, and we're gonna take everyone out like this and win the race this way. You can like collaborate and like strategize with the people, which is fun too.
これまずだってレースとかバトルに出るまでが楽しいでしょ。
ロボットだけでね。なんか夜中ずっと。
It's not just the race and battle itself. It's everything leading up to that. That's a lot of the fun part of the game. You know, customizing your robot and tweaking lots of stuff and giving them all kinds of like weapons and attacks and you know boosting stats and stuff like that. It's the kind of thing that you know you can end up just tweaking your robot until morning before you even.Finally start racing and stuff. It's really engrossing, really deep game. And we've got a message for everyone from the developer Mercury Studio. Break Arts 2 is a battle racing game in which you can make your very own completely unique robot and race and battle with it. You'll find all different kinds of parts and weapons and whatnot to combine together to make, again,your very own unique robot. And the main point of this game is to create your own robot that's, create your own robot and race more powerfully, more beautifully, and more badassedly than anyone else. So here's the next game, Light by Miwashiba.
さあこちらのタイトルはライイートでして、はい、では水谷さんこちらも解説といいますか、はい、詳しくお願いいたします。
Alright, so this is a game created by the developer named Miwashiba.
クリエイターさんのタイトルで、嘘を食べるドラゴンの
It's about a female dragon who eats lies.
ライト、イート、ライト。
Hence the name of the game.
嘘を食べるライト、イート、ライト。ライトっていうタイトルになってます、ね。はい、まあ、嘘を食べる能力はあ、青いリボンの女の子があの嘘を食べれるんです。
So the girl with the blue ribbon there, she has the powers of being able to pick out liars and eat their lies.
詐欺師の人なんですけど、
And the other guy there is just a big old pathological liar and a con man. And they join forces.
まあ自分たちの過去っていうのがなんか見えてくる。
In order to basically work out some problems and some issues they had with their respective pasts.
童話のような偶話のようなおとぎ話みたいなのが、まあ、RPG なんですけど、まあ、戦闘もあってっていうところ
It's an RPG game with some battle aspects and stuff, but a lot of it has a lot to do with sort of like fairy tales and like supernatural characters and stuff like that.
So it's a ウルフ RPG エディターというあのツールで作られてて、これもウルフ RPG エディターで作られてて
It was made with a Wolf RPG editor.
から、
like My Father and several other games that we got up on PlayStation.
移植したいなと思いまして、スイッチに今回展開することになりました。5月27日なので、再来週ですかね。はい。
So the latest version is going to be released on May 27th.
すごくあの名作ですね。
そうですね。
今か今かと狙っていた方も多くて、
可愛いゲームで、はい、とても心温まるというかなんでしょうね。
It's a really cute game, the kind of game that sort of warms your heart. So if that's the kind of thing that you're into, then again, by all means, check it out. And we've got a message from Miwashiba, the developer.
The title is Raito. と読みます。嘘を暴いて物理で殴るそんなゲームです。
The title is Raito. Basically, you pummel people with physics.
That's the point of the game.
That's not true. So, magic is very powerful, but hitting is faster. Ah, good.
Magic is nice. Yes. And I've always liked warm works before. I've always liked really sort of like heartwarming works
before. I've always liked really sort of like heartwarming works before. I've liked like picture books and stuff. So I wanted to make the kind of game that would be both fun and sort of heartwarming at the same time. It's not really difficult to pick up. So even people who aren't really into RPGs can probably pick it up pretty quickly. I put a lot of work into the design and many other parts of the game, so I'm really confident that players are going to appreciate the work put into it. So please check it out.
イラスト描いてもらったりとか、最適化したりつながるんで、フリーゲーム版、Steam でも出てるんですけど、はい、やった方、また再度スイッチでやってもらうと、なんか違う、新しい新鮮に楽しめるんじゃないかなと思います。
はい。はい、これもガッチさん好きそうって言われてるんですけど、そうなんですか、物理
ガッチさん、this seems like the kind of thing you might like too, huh?
でも、絵も可愛いです
ね。Well, yeah, I like the physical stuff of it, but it's also cute, and the story sounds good, so yeah, I like it for those reasons. So please, by all means, check out Light and try it out.
さあ、続きましてはこちらの映像をご覧
ください。Ooh, Grunosia.
こちらはもう言わずと知れたと言いますか、グノーシアですね。
This goes without saying, this was Gnosia.
では水谷さんに改めてちょっとこちらも詳しくお願いします。
So, Mr. 水谷, could you give us a bit of info about this one?
プチデポット、まあ、さっきからあの、はい、何回か出てますメゾンドマンを使った
プチデポット。 This is by the dev studio name is プチデポット, which we've brought up several times so far. They're the ones who made Unholy Heights.
AI の
It's a werewolf type game where you play against an AI instead of other live players. So the Gnosia is basically the werewolf. You're out in space, someone or some people among your crew members have been infected by this Gnosia, and you gotta figure out who they are before they kill you. So you've got to go through a bunch of debates and conversations with all the other crew members and try and suss out who exactly is a friend, who's a foe, who's the Gnosia this time, who's not the Gnosia this time. You go through these different time loops where each time the appearing characters and the roles they play change. And you've got to sort of roll with the punches and figure out, okay, so last time this person was a Gnosia, but this time I think it's maybe this person, but I need some more evidence. So you try and find evidence, try and get people on your side to back up your argument and stuff. And basically, yeah, you not only try to survive by figuring out who the Gnosia is, you also play through the game trying to figure out exactly why you're stuck in these time loops. What got you there? What are you supposed to do? How can you get out of them? What the hell is going on? So it's a werewolf RPG. RPG mystery type game, but it's also in a way a sort of adventure game as well. We released the English version of this game for the Nintendo Switch a little while ago. It was a real hit with the players. And so within 2021, we're going to be releasing the Steam version as well. The Steam version will be supporting not only English and Japanese, but Chinese as well.
And
we had a lot of we got a lot of comments from Chinese players saying, look, we really want a Chinese version, please put out a Chinese version. So for the Steam version, we're going to have Japanese, English and Chinese all covered.
そうですね、Steam 版はまだかというのはすごい声をいただきまして。
Yeah, we also had a lot of people asking like, hey, where's the Steam version? Where's the Steam version? When's it coming out? We've been thinking about it for a while, but once we realized that we actually probably would be able to port it without problem, then we decided, okay, we gotta get this done right away. So it'll be coming out this year. I don't really like werewolf games myself, mainly because I'm scared of people. I mean, playing like a werewolf game with other people, that's just embarrassing, you know? I assume everyone probably feels the same, but... But it's awesome the fact that you can play a werewolf game with just a computer and not have to, like, you know, look like a fool and like act like an idiot in front of other people. Because the AI in the game is it's actually really clever. And it really does, a lot of the time, feel like you're playing with actual other players. So it's a really, really well thought out, well put out, well put together AI and system. But yeah, the AI in this game is just ridiculously well done. So for people who are like, I'd like to try out a werewolf game, but yeah, it does feel kind of embarrassing. I'm a bit too shy. Screw that. Play Gnosia. It totally, you know, it's got you covered, man. Yeah, I totally get what Gatsuma was saying about wanting to play it but not wanting to get embarrassed. So yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Alright, so that's all for Gnosia.
さあこれまでねいくつかタイトルをご紹介してまいりましたが、ここからは今後の施策をご紹介します。では水谷さんお願いいたします。
Now we're gonna introduce a couple games that are gonna be coming out in the future. So we'll cut back over to Mizutani. What's up, Mizutani?All right, from here on out, we've got some guidelines we've set up for plays and titles as far as live streaming and Let's Plays go. These aren't exactly 100% enforced rules. These are more like guidelines that we'd appreciate if everyone would go by. Each title, you know, it's got its own conditions and stuff sometimes it might need to confirm with. But basically, it doesn't matter if you want to do a Let's Play or a live stream. We'll let you do it. Go for it. Please, you know, feel free. The next point is if you're going to be doing a live stream or Let's Play for profit, that too is totally okay, you know. Get money, man. We're not going to sue you. We're not going to tell you to, like, give us some of that cash. We're not going to say, oh, no, you can't use this for, you know, for profit. Go for it, man. Enjoy the game and get paid. The next rule is one thing we would like to request is that if you're going to be putting up live streams and stuff, please try to avoid spoilers as much as possible. The final semi-rule, I guess, that we have is please refrain from just tossing up videos that's nothing but, like, just a bunch of, like, cutscenes from the game. Like, don't just, you know, edit the game down to all the different, like, cinematic cutscenes and then put that together and slap that up on YouTube. Again, we're not going to sue you for it or anything, but we would really appreciate it if you just didn't do that. We'd like people to experience that stuff while they play the game, sort of organically. So, we'd appreciate it if you guys could be cool with that. Some more stuff we'd like to talk to you guys about is this is also regarding streaming and Let's Plays and stuff. We're participating in the Nico Nico the Nico Nico creator promotion program, I guess. Not all of our games, but some of our games qualify for this program. Basically what this is if you do a Let's Play or a live stream on Nico Nico video, and if you make sure to tie that Let's Play or live stream to the original game or to the game developer. For example, if the game you're playing is a spin-off or a remake or something like that, if you make sure to tie it to the original work and or the dev, then basically you can make some money off of that. Both the streamer and the original artist will be able to make a bit of profit off of that, which is kind of nice for everyone involved. This will be starting sometime around the beginning of June. And we've got about 25, 26 titles up here. But we've got about 10, 15 or so more titles that we're currently in talks with the devs to add to this program. So we have a pretty good amount of titles up here if you want to join up with the Nico Nico Creator Promotion Program. Anyway, it's a bit of a semi-complicated system, but it's not that hard to deal with. So we hope that anyone interested will try it out. Yes, if you'd like to try it out, then by all means, go ahead and try it out. This is basically just something that we introduced just because we just wanted to do any little thing that we could to kind of help out the developers of indie games in any way, you know, help get their games out a bit more, help get the word out a bit more, help get them paid a bit more, you know. One thing we'd like to avoid, though, is if you see somebody playing on YouTube and you're like, hey, you know, you could be doing this Nico Nico creator thing. Why are you doing it on YouTube, loser? Like, just try not to start shit like that with other users. We'd appreciate that. And as long as everyone's having fun with indie games, that's what's important for us. So just be excellent to each other. Yeah, we just hope this does something to help out indie games get hyped.
そしてさらにお知らせがあるということで
水谷さん、right, so、こちらも next, we've got some more announcements from 水谷。
はい、我々もともと EC サイトというかゲーム販売サイトをスタートからずっとやってて、
はい、
10周年を迎えるにあたって
We originally started using started out with an EC site back in the day. We actually closed down the PlayZim store in accordance with the PlayZim 10th anniversary.
大変ご迷惑もおかけしまして申し訳ないなと思っておりますが
Yeah, we feel really bad for causing trouble for both our players and our devs.
フィジカルのグッズを
Nothing's really going to change all that much. But because of that, we decided, hey, we've got some stuff in stock here, some package games and stuff, so maybe we should go ahead and sell some of these off.
ゲームどんだけ好きでも1本しか買わないじゃないですか。
そうなんですよね、
はい、めちゃくちゃ好きだけどメゾンドマオはやっぱ300円だから300円しか払えないんですけど、そうですね、メゾンドマオのグッズがもしあれば、はい、まあもしですよ、もしあれば、まあ、そういうのは、ねでデベロッパーに還元するきっかけになるのかなと思って、
トイレットペーパーとか日用品、
when you buy a game no matter how much you like that game you generally only buy it like once、
ね、
so we figured okay if we had like some game related merchandise then that would be、that could possibly be another way to help、help get some money back to our developers help show them some appreciation for all their work、so we've been considering、doing some specialGame、related good sales、merchandise sales、you see a lot of this stuff overseas、not so much of it in Japan so、we are、we're currently preparing to open up a store in which we would be able to help、various、indie developers、create and distribute these kinds of、game merchandise again in hopes to be able to sort of give something back and help out the、the dev community、
うん
それで盛り上げていただければいいんじゃないかなと思います、
はいはいね、個人的にねでも私あのもうまずゲームでダウンロードもね最近多いからね、はい、やっぱパッケージっていうのもすごくグッズとして一つ好きなところがある、
うん、そうですね、まあ、パッケージがね、
recently, コレクターアイテム化してますから、ね、a lot of games are like they only have downloaded versions and so recently I get sort of extra happy when I get a game with like an actual package version
もうダウンロードもでも物によるのかな
えげつないですよ、僕
は。ガッチマン、キリン、Do you guys prefer downloadable versions or physical versions?
映ってるのはありましたね。
もうすごいことになってますから、今ね。もう
地震の
床が抜けそうですよ。
大丈夫なんですか、なんかね。
あ、埼玉揺れないんですよ。
埼玉揺れないんですか
埼玉揺れないんですか
そんなことない。そんなことはないんですけど、今のところ大丈夫ですね。
大丈夫キリンさんも大丈夫ですか青森の方でしたっけ
あ青森はなかなか揺れますけど。
ね、揺れますよね。
私も昔からパッケージ派だったんですけど、最近はあの最近はというか、
I don't know what that was all about. But you're saying that recently he's been the package version games. And you know sometimes he'll play like several games at the same time.
わかる。
So sometimes you know I'll buy like the downloadable version of the game, and then you know I'll also end up buying the package version of the game, and it just something kind of happens sometimes.
利便性というか同じもうパソコンの中に全部
そうですね、ダウンロードはねやっぱすごい便利なので
ダウンロードバージョンは便利なので you've got everything you need like in one console or computer but there's a lot of people who like they want the package versions after all because you get stuff like you know you get the strategy guides or you know guidebooks for the games instruction books and stuff like that and you never see that kind of stuff anymore so it's always fun to get something like that in a package game especially if it's the kind of game that you don't know what the hell's going on and you know you got no idea how to even start the game it's nice to have something that tells you okay this is how you actually play it
私全部読んでるのかなと思ったら読んでたんですよ全然違うじゃないかとかたまに思いながらそうなんですよねどちらも良さがあってねそういったパッケージだったり
だから手元に残るものがあるといいのかな、
うん、パッケージバージョンとダウンロードバージョン they both got their good points、
はい、ぜひねこちらも、まあ、引き続きなんですけどハッシュタグプレイズムゲームショーとかでね俺はどっち派だとかでも何でもいいんですけれども
あそうなんかこういうのが欲しいとかね、うん、なんかわかんないですけど逆になんか
そう
なんですデベロッパーさんが
feel free to use the Playism Game Show hashtag to tell us anything you want you know, I prefer package versions I prefer downloadable versionsOr if there's any specific game that you'd like to see us publish, either for download or physical, let us know. Also, because of the whole pandemic thing, events have been, you know, canceled left and right. And a lot of people are like, wow, you know, without these events, there's not a whole lot I can do to promote my game. So if there's anyone out there who is like, you know, I'd really like to do some kind of event. I really want to get my game out there. I want to promote it. I want people to know about it. Feel free to contact us and maybe we can get something worked out. We plan to keep doing online events for the time being. So...Yeah, we'll see if we can maybe work together. Next up,
indie game developer 向けの
This is something we've been thinking about for a while, but We decided we wanted to put on a conference for the sake of indie game developers. A lot of the games that we've showed off so far are games that were made by just like one or two people, like some really brilliant people who are really good at what they do, but But the kind of stuff that these guys know how to do, they don't really have the opportunity to teach other people how to use these skills, how to develop these skills. And so we decided, okay, how about if we put together a conference where we can get all these like really brilliant creators together and try and spread around some of the wisdom, you know, like there are people who know how to create games on a team of like 100 people, but what if somebody like that wanted to create a game all on their own? Okay, well, we can hook up those people with these kind of dudes who are creating games on their own, just completely by themselves, and have them share their know-how and their skills and their different techniques with these people. But yeah, basically, we hope to provide the kind of a kind of space for people to come and learn as much as they need, as much as they want, as much as they can about indie games, about how to create these games, how to publish these games, how to promote them, how to make them better, basically how to turn this into their livelihood instead of just like a little hobby that they kind of tinker with once in a while.
ちょっと思い切ってそういうのをやろうかなっていうのを数年前から思ってたんですけど、はい、コロナが終わったらやろうかなと思って終わらないので、うん、もうオンラインでやろうかなというのをちょっと思っており、
Yeah, we've been thinking about doing something like this in person once the whole corona thing ends, but it's just doesn't seem to end, so we're not exactly sure how we're going to be doing it yet, but right now we're considering, we're planning putting it on sometime this summer, online for the time being. Sometime in June, we'll be announcing the specific details, so keep it out for those.
そうですね。また自分と違った視点が加わることにね、広がる世界がありますからね。
はい。
うん。ね、ぜひね、こちらによって。
Yeah, there's lots of stuff you can learn from, you know, other people, other points of view and stuff. So,
はい。
I feel that a lot of really interesting and cool games just may be born out of this, this conference in the future. So, yep, we'll be announcing the details in June. So, yeah, keep an eye out for them and look forward to it. We've still got yet more from Miyutani. There's one thing that I'm sure there's probably some people who've been watching this thinking, okay, this is what I've been waiting for. But we've got one little announcement. I'd like to speak about the game Omori. We got a video message for the game Omori. So here you go, check it out.
This
is a game that people, a lot of people have been waiting for. I've been checking out our Twitter timeline since before we even did this event, and there's been so many people being like, where's Omori? Where's Omori? Where's Omori? When's it coming out? When's it coming out? So we had to say something. Omori was developed by a developer named Omocat.
した引きこもりのおもりなんですけど、うん、をテーマにした、まあ、夢日記とかマザーとかを、
はい、The theme, the theme of the game is basically引きこもり、someone who can't leave their house for whatever reason、
アジア版というか日本語英語、日本語中国語韓国語かな、
and we're going to be publishing the、Asian version which will have、English, Japanese and Chinese included。
そうですね、一応前回プレイズムゲームショーの時に我々はインディーゲームを販売するにあたり、まあ、多種多様なゲームを、リリースするんだみたいな話をして、それは一つのなんか変にブランドの方向性決めずみたいなやっていくって言ったんですけど、やっぱ主にはプレイズムらしいゲームだなって思ってて、
didn't really seem like they might be coming from playism. You know, we want to release a whole wide variety of games. And when we first came across Omori, we thought, yeah, this actually does kind of feel like the sort of game that would come from playism. And so we decided to bend our little guideline there and put out another game that really was sort of playism-ish.
結実したような気に勝手に僕はなっていて、
I personally feel that you know, this 10 years that we've been dealing with indie games, playing Omori and looking at Omori now, I kind of feel like this is sort of the culmination of all these different indie games that we've published and localized and over the last 10 years. This is definitely a game that I wanted to get out there and I wanted to be able to publish.It's been doing really well overseas for a long time now, and I really just can't wait to be able to release it to Japan and the Chinese regions. It's just such a really great indie game, and again, it's sort of the culmination of like everything that we've been doing over the past 10 years as far as bringing indie games to the world. We're still working on the final touches right now.So just give us a little bit more time, and we'll get back to you guys again later with a proper date announcement and any other required details. Alright, so it's about time to wrap stuff up for the 10th anniversary Play Some Game Show. First, Kirin, any comments?
ようやくなんか緊張解けてきたかなと思
って。Yeah, finally kind of started being able to relax just now.
So. まあ終わりになってしまったんですけど、私も大森ずっとウィッシュリストに入れっぱで楽しみに待って。
I mean, you know, the show's over and everything, but I just wanted to say that I've had Omori in my wish list like since forever. So I can't wait for you guys to finally release that. I'm looking forward to it.
本当にゲームが好きなキリンさんだからちょっと伝わってくるものがありましたね。
Yeah, this Kieran dude really, really likes his video game.
そしてガチマンさん、今日 V、ガチマン V さんですね。
ガチマン V、any final comments?
やっぱでも毎回こう前回も出させていただいて今回も出させていただいたんですけども、やっぱりなんとか今までのさメーカー製のゲームっていうのはテレビの番組とか CM とかで見てたりしてて、結構情報は目に入るんだけど、インディーゲームってなかなかこう情報を手に入れるのが難しかった
ね。So I was on the last PlayZone game show, and you know, obviously I'm on this one now too. And I've been thinking for a while, like you learn about lots of other games like AAA games and stuff from like commercials and magazines and ads and stuff. But for indie games, you don't really get a whole lot of info about them, just you know, from the regular channels and stuff.
Indie game.がまた広まったんじゃないかなと思いますし、
But seeing events like this now and hearing a lot more people actually talking about indie games and people writing a lot more about indie games and you know, broadcasting more stuff about indie games, I really feel that finally indie games are really starting to come into their own.And I'm really glad to see how indie games have been turning out and really glad that we're able to do these kind of events now. So thanks a lot for having me. And
そうですね、
Mizutani, what do you have to say about the 10th anniversary of PlayZone?
今年ここから1年ですね、まあ、主にもあるんですし、ありますし、まあ、今発表したタイトルもありますけど、今日発表できなかったタイトルが、いくつかありまして、
We've also got several titles that are coming up that we weren't able to announce yet today.
で、
And probably in about the next year, we're going to have this pretty just badass lineup of games. Like the kind of lineup that's gonna make people be like, okay, well, what are you gonna do after this? Like, this is like the ultimate lineup. Like, where are you gonna go now? We've got some really bitching games coming up. Yeah, we're not gonna mention them now, but yeah, over this next year, we've got a lot of stuff coming out that we really can't wait to bring you guys.
いいなと思います。まあ今日発表したものも当然自信作というか素晴らしいタイトルばかりなので。
I mean, of course, the stuff that we introduced today are all titles we're really proud of and we're really confident are going to do well. But the stuff that we've got coming up in the pipeline in the future too, this is definitely stuff that you guys aren't going to miss. So look out for that.
デベロッパーとユーザーのおかげで僕ら人の他人のものを借りて売ってるだけなので。
And yeah, it really is thanks to the players and devs that we've been able to make it this far, you know, through 10 whole years. I mean, we really are just basically taking somebody else's thing and then selling that thing to other people. And so it really is all about the players and the devs.
いつの間にかなってパッケージ版とかやったりしてきたんですけど、まあその10年、この10年すごくそれがうまく機能したんですけど、まあこの先の10年っていうのはまた
And over this past 10 years, you know, a lot of stuff has gone all right for us, and we were able to release some packaged versions of games and some specialties and stuff like that.
But
for the next 10 years, we're trying to figure out what direction we want to go in, what exactly we want to do, you know.
And
we feel that there's definitely new and untapped ways to tap into the market of not just indie games, but non-indie games as well. Of course, we're going to keep focusing mainly on indie games, but we definitely want to sort of spread our wings and get into as much stuff as we can. Put really simply, we're hoping that we can do over the next 10 years the same kind of stuff that we were able to do over the past 10 years. Doing some new stuff, some all new stuff, doing some old stuff in a new way, in new ways. Most importantly, just bringing the kind of games to the kind of people who want to play them. And continuing to work with as many awesome games as we can. That's pretty much what I'm sure he was trying to say. So. Yeah, 10 years is a long ass time.
So, 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 so
はい、ぜひ引き続きよろしくお願いいたします。
よろしくお願いします。
そして最後に10周年の感謝を込めたキャンペーンのお知らせです。
Twitter
フォロワーのプレゼントツイート、そしてハッシュタグプレイズム10周年で名作タイトル、ね、まあ番組もそうなんですけど、感想投稿していただくと、なんとプレイズムの10年だけ様々な今遊んでほしい10タイトルのスチームキーが当たるキャンペーン実施いたします。こちら、なんと抽選で。
You can win Steam keys for the 10 titles that we at PlayAsm feel we most want you to play right now. Use the PlayAsm 10th anniversary hashtag on Twitter to tell us what game you want to play or game you like most. There will be details go up on Twitter later on, don't worry about it.
知名度上げてくれ
たらっていう。いや、私
も僕は最初テキストのチェックを、まあ、一応すごい翻訳者さんにやってもらったの最後確認含めてチェックを全部やらせてもらったのですごい思い出深いタイ
トルで Valhalla, I had a really good translator localize the game and I did the final check for all the text and the sort of catchphrase I think the English is something like you know, serve a cocktail that will change someone's day and change their life, whatever. I actually thought up the Japanese version of that, so I'm kind of proud of myselfthat phrase in Japanese sort of blew up a bit. It's kind of funny to think that out of all the copywriting I've ever done, that became like the most famous. Also, Momodora is another game that's sort of nostalgic for me. There was definitely a period back in the day when pretty much all of our salaries were being paid pretty much solely by Momodora. So that's another really important title that has a special place in my heart.
そしてもうこの後というかすでにオープンしておりますが、はい、22時からですね、Steam Store ではね、もうセールも始まっておりまして、再度改めてにお伝えしますと、まあ、
Right, and once again to go over the sales we got going on right now. There's sales going on both on Steam and the Nintendo eShop. For the exact dates, go ahead and rewind a bit to the beginning of this part because I missed what she said, or check out the Steam store or the Nintendo eShop. Thanks a lot everyone for coming. We hope you had a good time and hopefully we'll see you next time. Have a great evening. and stay safe.